Hello friends, welcome to this session on organization structures for project management. Once the management of a firm approves a project, the next question arises, how will the project be implemented? Which organization structure to use? There are three basic organization structures: functional organization, matrix organization, and pure project organization. Although not exhaustive, these structures and their variant forms represent the major approaches for organizing projects. Whether a firm chooses to complete projects within the traditional functional organization or through some form of matrix arrangement is only a part of the story. Anyone who has worked for more than one organization will tell you that there are considerable differences in the way a project is managed within certain firms with certain organization structures. Friends, a project management system provides a framework for launching and implementing project activities within a parent organization. A good system appropriately balances the needs of both the parent organization and the project by defining the interface between the project and parent organization in terms of authority, allocation of resources, and eventual integration of project outcomes into the mainstream operations. In the past, many business organizations have struggled with creating a system for organizing projects while managing ongoing operations. One of the major reasons for this struggle is that projects contradict fundamental design principles associated with traditional organizations. We have already studied, projects are unique, they are one-time efforts with a distinct beginning and end. But most organizations are designed to efficiently manage only ongoing routine activities. Projects are not routine and therefore can be like ducks out of water in these work environments. All right, now let us start our discussion on three types of organization structure for project management. Project as a part of functional organization. As one alternative for giving the project a home, we can make it a part of one of the functional divisions of the firm. Friends, look at the figure on the screen. It is the organizational chart for a hypothetical company, let's say Delta Manufacturing. It is a functionally organized institution. As you can see, the organization is divided into four basic functions of marketing, engineering, manufacturing, and procurement. Under each function, you have different sub-functions. Example, under marketing, you have customer service, domestic sales, and international sales. Similarly, under manufacturing, you have fabrication, assembly, testing, and production scheduling. Once the management decides to implement a project, different segments of this project are delegated to the respective functional units, with each unit responsible for completing its segment of the project. However, the coordination is maintained through normal management channels. The functional organization is commonly used when one functional area plays a dominant role in completing the project or has a dominant interest in the success of the project. Okay. So, let us now take a look at advantages and disadvantages of a functional organization of project management. Advantages: no change. Projects are completed within the basic functional structure of the parent organization. There is no need of radical alteration in the design and operation of the parent organization. Flexibility: there is maximum flexibility in the use of staff. If the proper division has been chosen as the project's home, the division will be the primary administrative base for individuals with technical expertise in the fields relevant to the project. Employees can be temporarily assigned to the project, make the required contributions, and immediately be reassigned to their normal work. With the broad base of technical personnel available in the functional divisions, people can be switched back and forth between the different projects with relative ease. In-depth knowledge. Specialists and experts in the division can be grouped to share knowledge and experience. Therefore, the project team has access to whatever technical knowledge resides in the functional group. This in-depth knowledge is a potential source of creative, synergetic solutions to technical problems. Base for continuity. The functional division also serves as a base of technological continuity when individuals choose to leave the project and even the parent firm. Perhaps just as important as technological continuity is the procedural, administrative, and overall policy continuity that results when the project is maintained in a specific functional division of the parent firm. Easy post-project transition. The functional division contains the normal path of advancement for individuals whose expertise is in the functional area. The project may be a source of glory for those who participate in its successful completion, but the functional field is their professional home and the focus of their professional growth and advancement. But friends, just as there are advantages to housing the project in a functional area, there are disadvantages as well. A primary disadvantage of this arrangement is that the client is not the focus of the activity and concern. The functional unit has its own work to do, which usually takes precedence over the work of the project and hence over the interests of the client. For example, the marketing department may consider the project urgent, while the operations department may consider it of secondary importance as compared to their routine work. Imagine the tension one department has to go through if it has to wait for the other department to give their input to them. The functional division tends to be oriented towards the activities particular to its function. It is not usually problem oriented in the sense that a project should be to be successful. Occasionally, in functionally organized projects, no individual is given full responsibility for the project. This failure to pinpoint responsibility usually means that the PM, project manager, is made accountable for some parts of the project, but another person is made accountable for one or more other parts. Little imagination is required to forecast the lack of coordination and chaos that results. The same reasons that lead to lack of coordinated effort tend to make response to client needs slow and tough. There are often several layers of management between the project and the client. There is a tendency to sub-optimize the project. Project issues that are directly within the interest area of the functional home may be dealt with carefully, but those outside normal interest areas may be given short shrift if not totally ignored. The motivation of people assigned to the project tends to be weak. The project is not in the mainstream of activity and interest, and some project team members may view service on the project as a professional diversion. Lastly, such an organizational arrangement does not facilitate a holistic approach to the project. Complex technical projects such as the development of a jet transport aircraft or an emergency room in a hospital may simply cannot be well designed unless they are designed as a totality. No matter how good the intentions, no functional division can avoid focusing on its unique areas of interest. Cross-divisional communication and sharing of knowledge is slow and difficult at times. All right, let us move on to the next type of structure, pure project organization. Pure project. Does the name itself give you any hint? Yes, you are right. In this type of structure, the project is separated from the rest of the parent system. It becomes a self-contained unit with its own technical staff, its own administration, tied to the parent firm only by periodic progress reports and oversight. Some parent organizations prescribe administrative, financial, personal, and control procedures in detail. Others allow the project almost total freedom within the limits of final accountability. Look at your screen. The figure illustrates pure project coordination. As seen in the figure, projects is considered as a separate vertical in the organization with multiple projects running under its wings. Manager for project A will have his own team comprising employees from marketing, manufacturing, finance, personnel, and research and development departments. So will manager of project B. So where is this type of structure most useful? It is most useful in organizations where projects are the dominant form of business, such as a construction firm or a consulting firm, where the entire organization is designed to support projects. Okay, So just like a functional organization, even a pure project organization has its unique advantages and disadvantages. Advantages. Complete authority. The project manager has full line authority over the project. Though the project manager must report to a senior executive in the parent organization, there is a complete workforce devoted to the project. The project manager is like the CEO of a firm that is dedicated to carrying out the project. All members of the project workforce are directly responsible to report to the project manager. There are no functional division heads whose permission must be sought or whose advice must be heeded before making technological decisions. The project manager is truly the project director. In a way, this means that unity of command exists. Speedy. When the project is removed from the functional division, the lines of communication are shortened. The entire functional structure is bypassed and the project manager communicates directly with the senior corporate management. The shortened communication lines result in faster communications and faster response times with fewer failures. Also, because authority is centralized, the ability to make swift decisions is greatly enhanced. The entire project organization can react more rapidly to the requirements of the client and the needs of senior management. Talent pool. When there are several successive projects of a similar kind, the pure project organization can maintain a more or less permanent cadre of experts who develop considerable skills in specific technologies. Indeed, the existence of such skill pools can attract customers to the parent firm. Cohesiveness. The project team that has a strong and separate identity of its own tends to develop a high level of commitment from its members. Motivation is high and acts to foster the task orientation. Simple. Pure project organizations are structurally simple and flexible, which makes them relatively easy to understand and to implement. Further, the organizational structure tends to support a holistic approach to the project. The dangers of focusing on and optimizing the project's subsystems rather than the total project are often a major cause of technical failure in projects. But I am sure you will acknowledge that while the advantages of pure project organization make a powerful argument favoring this structure, its disadvantages are also serious. When the parent organization takes on several projects, it is common for each to be fully staffed. This can lead to considerable duplication of effort in every area from clerical staff to the most sophisticated and expensive technological support units. If a project does not require a full-time personnel manager, for example, it must have one nonetheless, because project managers come in integers, not fractions, and staff is usually not shared across projects. In fact, the need to ensure access to technological knowledge and skills results in an attempt by the project manager to stockpile equipment and technical assistance in order to be certain that it will be available when needed. Thus, people with critical technical skills may be hired by the project when they are available rather than when needed. Similarly, they tend to be maintained on the project longer than needed, just in case. Removing the project from technical control by a functional department has its advantage, but it also has a serious disadvantage if the project is characterized by as high technology. Though individuals engaged with projects develop considerable depth in the technology of the project, they tend to fall behind in other areas of their technical expertise. The functional division is a repository of technical experience, but it is not readily accessible to members of the pure project team. Pure project groups seem to foster inconsistency in the way in which policies and procedures are carried out. In the relatively sheltered environment of the project, administrative corner cutting is common and easily justified as a response to the client or to technical demand. "They don't understand our problems" becomes an easy excuse for ignoring requests from headquarters. In pure organizations, the project takes on a life of its own. Team members form strong attachments to the project and to each other. A disease known as projectitis develops. A strong we-they divisiveness grows, distorting the relationships between project team members and their counterparts in the parent organization. Friendly rivalry may become bitter competition, and political infighting between projects is common. Another symptom of projectitis is worry about life after the project ends. Typically, there is considerable uncertainty about what will happen when the project is completed. Will team members be laid off? Will they be assigned to low prestige work? Will their technical skills be too rusty to be successfully integrated into other projects? Will our team, that old gang of mine, be broken up? All right. Now let us move on to the next and the last type of project organization structure, which is the matrix organization. In an attempt to couple some of the advantages of the pure project organization with some of the desirable features of the functional organization and to avoid some of the disadvantage of each, the matrix organization was developed. In effect, the functional and the pure project organizations represent extremes. The matrix organization is a combination of the two. It is a pure project organization overlaid on the functional divisions of the parent firm. Being a combination of pure project and functional organization structures, a matrix organization can take on a wide variety of specific forms depending on which of the two extremes, functional or pure project, it most resembles. The project or strong matrix most resembles the pure project organization. The functional or weak matrix most resembles the functional form of organization. Finally, the balanced matrix lies in between the other two. In practice, there is an almost infinite variety of organization forms between the extremes, and the primary difference between these forms has to do with the relative power, decision authority of the project manager and the functional manager. Let us first consider a strong matrix, one that is similar to a pure project rather than being a standalone organization. Consider the figure on your screen. The project manager of project 1, PM1, reports to a program manager who also exercises supervision over other projects. Let us say project 1 has assigned to it 3 people from the manufacturing division, 2 people from marketing, 1 person each from finance and personnel, and 4 individuals from R&D. These individuals come from their respective functional divisions and are assigned to the project full time or part time depending on the project's needs. It should be noted that the project manager controls when and what these people will do, while the functional managers control who will be assigned to the project and what technology will be used. Now, with heavy representation from manufacturing and R&D, project 1 might involve the design and installation of a new type of manufacturing process. However, project 2 could involve a new product or possibly a marketing research problem. Project 3 might concern the installation of a new computerized financial control system. But while all this is happening, all the while, the functional divisions continue with their routine activities. There is no single executive to whom project managers generally report. If a project is merely one of several in a specific program, the project manager typically reports to a program manager if there is one. It is not uncommon, however, for the project manager to report to the manager of the functional area that has a particular interest in the program or an interest in the project if it is not part of the program. Okay, having taken a look at strong matrix organization, let us move ahead. At the other end of the spectrum of matrix organizations is the functional or weak matrix. A project might, for example, have only one full-time person, the project manager. Rather than having an individual functional worker actually assigned to the project, the functional departments devote the capacity to the project, and the primary task of the project manager is to coordinate the project activities carried out by the functional department. For example, the project manager of a project set up to create a new database for personnel might request that the basic design might be assigned by senior management or might be result of negotiations between the project manager and the head of the systems group. The priority given to the design might be assigned by senior manager or might be the result of negotiations between the PM and the head of the systems group. In some cases, the systems group charges for the job might also be subject to negotiation. The task could even be subcontracted to an outside vendor. Between these extremes is the balanced matrix, which is typically anything but balanced. There are many different mixtures of project and functional responsibilities. When a functional group's work is frequently required by projects, it is common to operate the group as a functional unit rather than to transfer its people to the project. For instance, a toxicology unit in a cosmetic business, a quality assurance group in a multi-product manufacturing firm, or a computer graphics group in a publishing firm might all be functionally organized and take on project work much like outside contractors. While the project management's control over the work is diminished by this arrangement, the project does have immediate access to any expertise in the group and the group can maintain its technology integrity. Now, the matrix project organization has advantages and disadvantages, which are a combination of functional and pure project organizations. Let us see what the advantages are. The project is the point of emphasis. One individual, the project manager, takes responsibility for managing the project, for bringing it in on time, within cost, and to specification. The matrix organization shares this virtue with the pure project organization. Because the project organization is overlaid on the functional divisions, temporarily drawing labor and talent from them, the project has reasonable access to the entire reservoir of technology in all functional divisions. When there are several projects, the talents of the functional divisions are available to all projects, thus sharply reducing the duplication required by the pure project structure. There is less anxiety about what happens when the project is completed than is typical of the pure project organization. Even though team members tend to develop a strong attachment for the project, they also feel close to their functional home. Response to client needs is as rapid as in the pure project case, and the matrix organization is just as flexible. Similarly, the matrix organization responds flexibly and rapidly to the demands made by those inside the parent organization. A project nested within an operating firm must adapt to the needs of the parent firm or the project will not survive. With matrix management, the project will have access to representatives from the administrative units of the parent firm. As a result, consistency with the policies, practices, and procedures of the parent firm tends to be preserved. If nothing else, this consistency with parent firm procedures tends to foster project credibility in the administration of the parent organization, a condition that is commonly undervalued. When there are several projects simultaneously underway, matrix organization allows a better company-wide balance of resources to achieve the several different time, cost, performance targets of the individual projects. This holistic approach to the total organization's needs allows projects to be staffed and scheduled in order to optimize total system performance rather than to achieve the goals of one project at the expense of others. The advantages of the matrix structure are potent, but the disadvantages are also serious. Disadvantages involve conflict between the functional and project managers for the most part. In the case of functionally organized projects, there is no doubt that the functional division is the focus of decision-making power. In the pure project case, it is clear that the project manager is the power center of the project. With matrix organizations, the power is more balanced. Often, the balance is fairly delicate. When doubt exists about who is in charge, the work of the project suffers. If the project is successful and highly visible, doubt about who is in charge can foster political infighting for the credit and glory. If the project is a failure, political infighting will be even more brutal to avoid blame. While the ability to balance time, cost and performance between several projects is an advantage of matrix organizations, that ability has its dark side. The set of projects must be carefully monitored as a set, a tough job. Further, the movement of resources from project to project in order to satisfy the several schedules may foster political infighting among the several project managers, all of whom tend to be more interested in ensuring success of their individual projects than in helping the total system optimize organization-wide goals. For strong matrices, problems associated with shutting down a project are almost as severe as those in pure project organizations. The projects having individual identities resist death. Even in matrix organizations, projectitis is still a serious disease. In matrix organized projects, the project manager controls administrative decisions and the functional heads control technological decisions. The distinction is simple enough when writing about project management, but for operating project manager, the division of authority and responsibility inherent in matrix management is complex. The ability of the project manager to negotiate anything from resources to technical assistance to delivery dates is a key contributor to project success. Success is doubtful for a project manager without strong negotiation skills. Matrix management violates the management principles of unity of command. Project workers have at least two bosses, their functional heads and the project manager. Anyone who has worked under such an arrangement understands the difficulties. As industry experts rightly say, matrix management is a charming form of management full of variety and disorder. This brings us to the end of this session. Today, we have studied three different types of organization structures for project management and their advantages and disadvantages. I hope you have enjoyed the learning. Thank you.